Provisioning means which module you want to provision on this particular device. So this module can be LTM, this module can be GTM, this module can be ASM, this can be any number of the modules. So modules, when you are provisioning, there are few options which we talked about in yesterday class, but let me give you an overview again. It can be have the dedicated means this whole system will be dedicated for that particular module only, okay. It can be have the nominal means like it is having such resources which is required for that particular module. It can be have minimum means we are squeezing all the resources and we are just saying that you will be getting only these resources available. None means you are not opting for any kind of module. Hello, am I audible, guys? Hello.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So this is all about your licensing and provisioning. Okay. And into provisioning, I already told you that there are a couple of the modes that is dedicated, nominal, minimum, and none. And we are checking all of this stuff right away. Okay. So dedicated means what? Dedicated means the module is only dedicated for all of that module. Okay. And it is all the CPU and all of the resources will be allocated to that. Nominal means fair. Minimum means squeezing one. None means none of the resources. Okay. Then what is that? Okay. We will be doing it later on. Let me skip that part. Huh? Let me go to our big IP system. So how we went to the big IP system? Just using the management IP over the HTTPS, I logged into this device, and currently my device is not having the license. You can see that this device license is expired, or if your device is not having the license, again you will be having similar kind of screen with some different messages. Okay, so you need to do the same thing. I am reactivating it, you need to only activate it. Only couple of the difference would be there, but the rest thing will be same. So before doing it, what we need to have? We need to have F5 keys. For F5 keys, what I told you, you need to go to the F5, maybe you can say F5 key trials, okay, and you just go to the trials key, you log in over there, okay, using your username and password. Okay, once you are registered over there, you can see that, okay, get a free trial and something like that. And if you are there, then login and registered. Okay, I am logging and registering it. Okay, the same link which I provided you. What happened? I am logging into it using my mail ID and password. Once you are there, you need to say that, okay, I want to download the keys. Okay, this is the same message which I was showing you. It is saying what is the purpose of this trial. Just say that I want to evaluate it. It is asking what is your job function. Just say that I am network engineer or whatever suits to you. Then, okay, which trial you would like to have? I am saying big IP, virtual edition. Then it is saying how many licensing you will have. Guys, you can have 3 keys in one go. So select for 3. Okay. Although these 3 keys will be expired on the same day. Okay. But it's all right. You just go for the 3 keys, because for one email ID, you can maybe generate for 3 times. Okay. It will be for your 30 days. Then you need to put the black, like 0, then D, then N, and then just click over here and you will get the keys, because I have already done it. So I am not going to do it again. Otherwise my third part will be over. So once it will be done, you will receive an email from the big IP system, company, that okay, these are the keys which you can use for your usage. And you will be having the keys in the format of, like, let me show you quickly. So where is the key? Where is my key? Let me copy it and let me paste it right away. So this is the key. Okay, so this is the key which I received from big IP system. Now what I need to do, I need to click over this reactivate. Okay guys, if anyone has any question, you can ask me 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, but these are very important questions. If you have any doubt, you just raise the flag. Okay, I am putting it over the reactivate, but you can click over the activate. Since there is something already over there, I am clicking over the edit. I am just deleting it because it was the old key or something like that. I am just copying, cut. I am pasting it over here, right? And I am clicking over the revert next. And you can see it is loading something, or maybe it is doing couple of the stuff. Huh? I'm sorry, it is DEOF. It is taking the previous key again. Wait for a while. So cancel. Okay, let it be done first. So sometime it throws such kind of errors. Do not worry, okay? It will come online after some time. It will take some time. So far, any question to the new persons who joined today only? Okay, let us go to the reactivate. Any question, guys? No? Okay. So we are just clicking whatever the key is, we are clicking over the next. And when we are clicking over the next, you can see that the device is, you know, loading and receiving the configuration something. So it is doing and it is creating the dossier file. So I talked about the dossier, right? So this is how the dossier is getting created. So for that, first of all, you should have the keys available to you. And for getting the key, you should have each and you should have registered with F5. You should be providing your email ID, and you should be providing that for what is the purpose of the keys and what all of the stuff. Okay, again, it will take some time. This process will take time only first time. Okay, and after that you need not to repeat these steps for 30 days, right? After 30 days your license will expire if it is a license version, lab version, evaluation version. But if you wanted to use the license, you can go ahead and you can ask your F5 that I wanted to use license for my labs, and so, okay, they will be providing it in some, they will charge for it, and it will be providing you the license for some more days, okay. What happening? Oh, I am sorry. I didn't click over the, you know, manual stuff, and that is the reason it was going to the automatic. Can you see? I told you the activation method can be automatic and manual. By default, it will be automatic. So you need to select the manual if you wanted to go for the manual way. Okay. So this time it will be generating the dossier, and you can create the dossier file. So I just overcome that. Okay. So you need to remove the auto, maybe you need to click over the manual kind of stuff if you need to do each and everything by your own. Otherwise, if your device is having the internet access, you just click over the automatic as it was, okay, and it will be automatic going to the internet, and it will be automatically fetching all the details for you, and it will be giving you the license from there. So do not, you know, refresh this kind of screen when it is coming. Just wait for a while, okay? And it will be showing you each and everything. If you press continue, this time you can see that a dossier is provided to you, right? So this is your dossier file. And this is an F5, like doing some kind of language over here. You cannot diagnose like what are the information mentioned into it, but it is binding up with your NTP information, your serial number, maybe your keys, and all of that stuff is there, okay? So you just press Control A, press Control C, and click over here, step two, the license, okay? Once you are clicking it, you can see it is going to the activate F5 where you need to enter the dossier. You just paste it over here, Control V, or else you can download or you can select the file from here. All depend upon you. Click over the next. It will ask for the EULA. Okay, accept your user legal agreement, accept it, and press the next. Okay. Once you will be doing this, you will be having the license available to you. Even into your license, there are more and more information available. You can see that, okay, this is the license, okay, and it will be telling you that, okay, what are the modules which I need to go for, okay, it is telling you what is enabled, what is not. It is a trial version for 30 days, it is giving you, okay, and it will be showing you that this is the serial number of the device, and these are all the details. So maybe you, if you wanted to check all of this information, like the dossier, you can see the dossier information is there. Can you see this is your registration key, right? The registration key which I put on over here, and what is the license version, what is the image version of your device, what is performance ID, what is service check date. Service check date is a very important question also, and when you are doing upgrade of your device, it will be used. Okay, I will be let you know when we will be doing or when we will be reading about the upgrade kind of stuff. Okay, then what is the license start date? Can you see the license start date will be what? The 13th of your September, okay, for today. So it is starting from here, and end date would be what? End date would be your one month, after 1 month, right? So this is all of the information which it is providing into this licensing file. Guys, are you getting this point? Are you with me? Am I audible?
Yeah.
Yes.
Everything is okay. So just press Control A, press Control C, okay, go to your device again, and here into the license, press over here, press Control V, and your license will be copied out over here, which you are copying it from your F5 licensing server. Just press next. Either it is your new device, either you are reactivating, I am showing you these steps. These steps are important, okay? And I am telling you again and again with respect to the interview also, with respect to your new device, when you are building up your new device, then also, okay? So these steps are very much important. Sorry. So let's wait for some time. It will give you again the message that, okay, the device is licensed. Then we will be going for provisioning. What we were saying, that provisioning is which modules you wanted to access, and it all depend upon your RAM and each and everything. Like if you wanted to, maybe in your lab setup you wanted to enable LTM, GTM, AVR or much and much modules, because all of these modules can be enabled, by the way, in the evaluation license, okay? But it will throw the error that you don't have the resources. So in that case, how to increase the RAM for it, I will let you know, okay? When you will be going to the classes, I will be telling you each and every stuff at that time. Just press continue, okay, and you can see the license kind of error message is now gone, okay? But you need to do the provisioning, or maybe I don't know if provisioning will come to me or no, because this device was already provisioned, but I can show you the provisioning, don't worry. Let it come up first. It is booting or loading the files. By the way, meanwhile, let us check over here. And let me press enter. Can you see? Earlier it was saying license expired, but this time it is, that message is not no more available. Okay, it is showing offline because still it is, you know, in the phase to doing something, coming up with some resources. It usually take all of this step, you know, usually take that time. But don't worry. let it get booted first. Okay, let it come up. Okay, maybe if you wanted to see now what is happening, you can use this command tail minus f var log LTM. I am saying that I wanted to see that what is in the background is happening, because it is a lab environment. I can run this command. Yeah, so you can see that it is going and it is checking. Okay, virtual server is also there. Earlier it was not showing me the virtual server, remember, when I was showing you the TMSH kind of command. But now it is coming up with each and everything, that okay, how many virtual server I am having any kind of LTP, I am having any kind of iRule, I am having any kind of monitors, or maybe any kind of persistence. So all of the daemons are running over there and it is checking. Yeah, Hirin, any question?
Yeah, so sir, this is kind of console log, is it?
Can you repeat again?
I'm saying, is this kind of the console log or?
It is kind of console. You
if
can
I
say,
want
no,
to
no,
see
no.
that,
no,
let's
no,
say. For,
no, no, it is not console. It is your SSH. Okay? Console is your, maybe through the VMware you can take. Okay,
but these are the logs, right?
These are the online logs, or the real time logs, you can say.
Okay, and what command did you use? Tail minus f var
LTM. Don't worry. We will be doing each and every command in very much, you know, deeper way. We will be going through the classes, and then you will be able to understand. Okay. So, by the way, for your curiosity, let me show you. So, this is the command: tail minus f, then var, then log, then LTM. The real time logs. I am checking it. So it is, you know, it is showing that, okay, full configuration, initialization, phase triggered, okay? And now all the daemons are like basically your processes which are coming. Can you see? Earlier it was offline and currently it is showing some another thing, right? So it is taking some time and it will be come up in within some time, okay? So this process, see, something is restarting, getting offline, couple of the steps is coming on in the background. So you can see that when it will be available, it will be showing you that, okay, the device is available for you now. Let me see if it is asking for the provisioning again or no. So currently also it is showing offline because still the process are running in background. Okay, so don't worry, it will take some time. Okay, this device when boots up, it takes some good time. When you are doing such kind of steps, it will take some time. So just have patience, it takes some time. Okay, even when you are doing, you know, some kind of upgrade activity, in that you need to take a good window. Okay, the time window, not the downtime window, only the time window. Reason behind, your FI devices will be in the pair always. It should be in the active standby unit, and you will be doing the upgrade always on the standby unit first. Okay, so in case of that, your traffic will not impacted. It is only your one device first upgraded, then second device upgraded. When we will be come to the upgrade now, then I will let you know that what should be the best practices so that your time window can be minimized. Okay, we will talk about that later on. Okay, so first let this come up. Let me check the device. Still it is, you know, not up. Still it is not up. Can you see now it is in inoperative mode? Okay, can you see the modes are also getting changed? Okay, it is all depending upon your daemons which it is starting up. Okay, earlier it was license expired, then it is going with couple of the phases. Okay, it is bit like other vendors also. Okay, but it depends, like if some devices, okay, provisioning is successful. Can you see provisioning is already done, so it is successful, but it's all right. There are some options to done the provisioning again. I will be showing with those alternate methods, but first time when you will be doing for you provisioning window. Okay, it is active now. It is showing the active. Is it active or no? No, it is still starting, still in operative mode. Okay, so let it start.
So sir, how many modes are there in order to go from offline to active?
Sorry, Hiren?
I mean, in order to, move from offline to active, how many nodes are there?
There are many, there are multiples, but let it boot, okay? Because there are these are their internal process. It is not bit like your, OSPF stages that we need to learn about. Nobody asked that question.
Yes.
Nobody asked that question.
Yes.
So it is not your big IP states or maybe the OSPF states. So do not get confused with that. So it is the inbuilt function, and nobody is going to ask about these kind of phases.
Yeah, because I just, want to know, if, as you said,
I got your point. I got your point that you are from the networking background and you should be triggered with that question. Yeah. Okay, it is active now. Perfect. So, your box is in active mode now. If you will see here, go to the login and you will be seeing that this earlier it was showing you offline and now it should be going to the active. Can you see? It is active and it is showing you standalone. Reason behind, currently it is a single unit. When we will be doing HA, you will be find out either the role will be active or either the role will be standby, or depends upon your environment how you want it to deploy in your environment. So this screen will be coming out after the provisioning in your scenario, but since I am reactivating it, for me it is showing me directly. Okay, but let me go to the resource provisioning. Let me show you like what kind of screen you guys will be having and what you need to do. You can just replicate that, and it is very easy, believe me. So like I wanted to deploy my ASM module, I will select on this part. And whatever I wanted to use, maybe the minimum dedicated or nominal, whatever, okay, I can use that. But currently, if I click over here, can you see it? It is showing me that the memory is having the issue. So it will show you that either it is having the issue or no. So LTM, I am selecting nominal and I am not running any of other module over here, okay? And that is the reason only LTM will be showing. If I will use ASM, the security module will be appeared over here, okay? When we will be doing the ASM lab, if you will come to the ASM batch, you will be able to see that ASM will be there, okay? And all of those stuffs will be coming on, and it all depend upon your resource provisioning, okay? Then, if you see the LTM...
Yes, sir, one quick question.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so these are all the modules, is it? I mean, the LTM, ASM, CGNet,
correct.
MGM.
Correct.
MGM is a module?
Yes. So these are all modules which you can, you can take the license for. And if you have the license, you can select it, like GTM. GTM is what? DNS. Okay, you will select it, the DNS will be activated. ASM, Application Security Manager. LTM, you are doing that. Okay, Access Policy Management, when you are doing maybe some AAA kind of stuff. AVR, if you wanted to get the reporting and all of those stuff in a very great extent. So different modules. Now, for you...
So sir, this management is to be...
Sorry?
What one or... How it is?
Come closer to the mic.
Can you go back?
Where? Into the resource provisioning?
Can you go back?
Into the resource provisioning, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct.
Yeah,
that management one, right? That is the default one, or that is the different...
That is the default, right? Some of the resources will be allocated by its own.
Okay.
For the management perspective and all of that.
Yeah, thank you.
So that will be coming by default. You are not doing anything. So here you can see there is a local traffic module. We will be covering this module in our class, and we are touching some more parts like network part and system part. Okay. And you will be seeing that if you wanted to maybe create some local users, you will go to the users, you will be creating some kind of users over here, and each and every steps you wanted to do the OCS backup, the SCF backup, you will be using this, going to the support for the QK view, what is the QK view and all of that stuff. We will be doing file management, software management for your, you know, upgrading images and all. So you will be, we will be playing system, we will be playing with the network, like what are the routes, what are the interfaces. If you will see interfaces, there is the interfaces name as 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. It is a bit different than the Cisco, but we will be covering each and every step in a very good detail using the slides only. Okay, so far, any doubt to anyone, guys? Any question for anyone, you can ask. Otherwise, I will be proceeding further. No question? Okay, let me you know, start one of my backend server so that this red should not be there. Currently it is, all of them are red because my backend servers are not up and the monitoring is on. Okay, so let me on them. Meanwhile, let us proceed with our slides. So it is showing you what, when you will be, you know, going up with the first phase, it will be showing you, do you want to change the management IP or no? You can put it, do you want to change the host name, time zone, root password, admin password, whatever you want to change, you can change it later on also, at that time also. Okay, so you can use this kind of utility, setup utility, when you are doing resource provisioning. Or one thing more, whenever you are seeing this blue screen, can you see over here? This means it is your mandate stuff. Rest stuff can be ignored, but this mandate means you need to put it on always. Okay, then it is showing you the root password, admin password, whatever the password you wanted to use, you can use here. You can play with which IP should be accessed for the SSH, that kind of stuff you can use. Okay, and here is the your, we will be talking about these all stuff when we will be doing, you know, HA. So leave it for now. When we will be doing HA, we will be telling you. Then it is showing you that how your big IP system will work. In your big IP system, whatever module you are going to, okay, it will having some modules into it. Into this some modules, you are selecting one of them. It will be showing you that I am into the network. Into the network, I am into the interface. I am into the interface list. And this is my interface list, as I showed you earlier. Each interface can be with your access port, can be with your trunk port. It all depends. Okay, either it is access port or trunk port. It each and everything will be depend upon your configuration or on your setup, how you need to do. Then if you clicking over this F5, okay, let me show you what I am talking about. This F5, if I will click over here, you will be having this kind of utility. This is known as setup utility. Here you can just go ahead and you can run whatever the utility you wanted to do. Okay, although all of these steps can be used over here also. Okay, but if you wanted to run from here, this is your certification question, that either the setup utility will be used for your HA or no. So you need to say yes, HA should be used from here. And there is something known as device management, which we will be covering in our HA lab. Here we will be performing each and every step for the HA, either it is a PRIP, either it is a traffic group, device trust, whatever. Okay, we will be covering over there. So there is something known as help. If you are going to the help and you wanted to check couple of the steps for what thing you wanted to go, maybe you are going to the local traffic, you are going to the policies, okay, maybe profiles, you are clicking over the profiles. If you are under the profile and you are clicking over the help, you will be having the help of the HTTP profiles. Then the profile related. If you are going to the iRules, you are into the iRules, you are clicking over the help, you will be getting the help regarding to the iRules. So whatever you select, maybe you are going to the nodes, okay, you are into the nodes, and you can see, by the way, one of my node is up, and your virtual server should be up, whosoever using this node. And earlier it was, you know, red, it is now green. So if you are into the nodes, you are going to the help, the specifically to that topic, your help is there, okay, and you can read about that. So that is how your basic steps you can use in your big IP system. Okay, then we will be covering the setup utility we have already talked about. Okay, about means if you are going over here, it will be talking about what are the things and what are not. Then context sensitive help we talked about, that in which manner you wanted to have the help, you can take the help from that side. Let us quickly finish one more thing, that is known as your deployment, or when you are doing the migration maybe. So let us suppose your production environment don't have the F5 available right away, and you want to deploy the F5. So how you will be doing? You can do in two forms. Either you can use one arm mode, either you can use two arm mode. One arm mode usually used there where the already production is alive and you don't want to move your cables and all of those stuffs. You will put the F5 in between. You will be playing with the routing stuff, okay, and the traffic will be coming in and coming out from the big IP, which is going to the end server. I will be telling about it, don't worry, in some time. And two arm means, let me show you the diagram first. So here, if you will talk about, we have two sites, site A and site B. We have two F5s, F5 over the site A, F5 over the site B. In this site, when the server traffic is coming over the WAN or howsoever, it is going over here, going to the F5, coming from the F5, then going to the server. Then maybe we are doing and we are playing with the routing stuff, that server is also going the traffic over here and the reverse traffic is going on. This is one arm deployment. It will be done when we don't want to touch our running environment, and over the one port, one arm you can say, over the one port we are doing the in and outbound traffic. And usually when you are having maybe one Palo Alto or maybe some kind of checkpoint or some kind of firewall which should be come in between when any traffic is coming to your F5, you can be having it one mode, or maybe you can have two firewall, then you can be having two arm mode. So it all depend upon your environment to environment, how your environment is set up. Like in this way, the inbound traffic and outbound traffic are going through different arms. Okay, so it all depends how you wanted to configure it. Each and every deployment mode has their own pros and cons. Okay, then if you will be talking about the same, we can check that one arm mode is used when the application traffic flow through the system coming going from one physical line. Okay, in that case, if you are using partitioning only, then you can use different subnets. Otherwise, each and everything will be on the same subnet. How we will be talking about later on in our classes, don't worry. But this is a overview class, so I am just providing you the overview. If you don't want to use that kind of setup and you wanted to use maybe I have different subnets, I wanted to do the routing and all of that stuff, then okay, go ahead and do the two arm mode, or the routed mode deployment. So again, one arm mode, two arm mode, or the routed mode can be your interview question. Okay, and there the interview can ask you a very trickier question, that okay, if one arm you are using, how many subnets you can use. Then the interview wanted to ask regarding your partitioning knowledge, then you can provide the partition about the partition also. Okay, yes Sirin.
Sir, I didn't get this.
Don't worry, we will be talking about it. We will be talking about it later on also. Okay, just I am providing you the overview that F5 can have the same port for the in and out than one arm. If you have different ports available, okay, then it is two arm. Again, it will be having different models also, that you are creating a port channel kind of stuff. Okay, that we will be discussing when we will be covering our subsequent classes. Don't worry. Okay. So that is all about today. Okay, today's class was of 1 hour, but we have covered maybe 1 hour and 30 minutes or so. So thanks for attending this session. Okay, guys, if you have any question, you can ask me. If you wanted to have any suggestions, you can ask me. Or the one who are new, let me show you something. Okay, for you guys, so that okay, maybe we have not covered this. Yeah. Okay, I stopped the recording, but it's all right. Let me show you. So if you are going to the virtual servers, okay, and if you see that I have some virtual server, maybe let us pick this virtual server, okay. We will be running up the lab like that, and we will be doing maybe HTTPS kind of stuff. And I am using my virtual IP. Virtual IP means the IP which I am covering over or creating over the big IP system. Then we will be opening up with what happened. Perfect. So sometime such kind of issue can come, and in that case the troubleshooting is something. Let me do the troubleshooting. Let me do the workaround very quickly. Just give me a minute. Okay. Where is my network adapter? I need to disable it and enable it again. 192.168. It is your external IP. I need to disable it and I need to enable it back. And where is my internal IP? I need to disable it and I need to enable it back. Let me check quickly either I can access my background server or not. 22, it is accessible. What about my big IP unit now? The external IP, perfect. So this is how your big IP system is opening the same server, but you are going through the big IP system. So we will be doing, you know, I will be providing you these virtual servers and all of that stuff. Okay. Okay. So this is our website. The one who are the new, you can go to our website using this link. Okay. Just wait for a minute. Let me close this. So this is our website. You can go and you can check our website. Okay, not for the LTM, but for other courses also. If you wanted to check the LTM, go to the training, go to the F5, check the LTM. Okay, and you will be able to find out whatever the syllabus we are doing, whatever are the things we are covering. Okay, so you can check each and everything. Maybe the one symbol with this, you can just cover up. Okay, and you will be able to see that, okay, what are the things we are performing and what we are covering in our classes. So you can see that there we are, you know, going with all the things from the basic, like installation and initial setup, which we have covered in today's class also. Load balancing, monitors, virtual servers, persistence, okay, processing SSL traffic. We will be talking about the SSL traffic, NAT, SNAT, what are they, iRules, IAPS, LTPs, high availabilities, how to maintain the big IP system, troubleshooting, running the TCP dump, having the QK view, how the VNSCP will be used, lot of stuff you will be able to see on our website. Okay, you can go over there. If you wanted to have some question related to the syllabus, you can check there. And we are having this syllabus from 24 to 26 hours. It all depends, okay, plus minus, it depends. So you will be having a working professional as a trainer whosoever is available. Like for this batch, I will be taking your batch, okay, end to end. Then the course content, 24 hours will be plus. Then instructor-led training, we are aware about it. Recorded session means I am providing you all kind of recording. If you are having any kind of issue, you can check those recording again and you can get it clear. Otherwise, I will be creating a group. Okay, those who have already enrolled for it, they are the part of that group. You can put up your questions onto that WhatsApp group. Either your colleagues, either me, either anyone else will be providing you the answers of your questions, where you can create a group, and it depends upon you how you can utilize that much and much for your for enhancing your knowledge. Okay, so this is all about, and it is your weekend classes. That is 2 hours for Saturday, okay, and 2 hours for Sunday. So it will be maybe 1.5 to 2 months, okay, approx. Any other question to anyone, guys, who are the new for today? No?
No, sir, that's good.
Okay, that's good. So for today, we are wrapping up the session, okay, it's